Greetings, travelers. This video contains spoilers for Act 3. I will show you how to maximize the loot in House of Hope and how to deal with Raphael in Act 3. First, you'll need to continue the story until you reach Devil's Fee and speak with Helsic. After paying her for services, head to the room upstairs to use the teleport to House of Hope. Make sure to grab a long rest before you get there, as long rests are turned off in that location. Place 5 items: Skull, Incense, Coin of Mammon, Diamond, and Infernal Marble, as shown on the screen. After entering House of Hope, speak to Hope and get clothes that will make members of this location friendly to you. Head over to the first room. There you can speak with Infernal Mason for a piece of lore and you can loot this room. Then head to the East Corridor. You are free to loot all the chests on the corridors. You can explore first doors on the right to the Portal Room for a bit of lore and information. Then head further north. Now that we looted and explored everything up to the doors shrouded by Mystic Force Curtain, we will backtrack east to their balcony facing outside. Jump through the rocks until you reach bedroom. Entering bedroom, you'll have to face Haarlep. There are several possible outcomes. Two main ones are either kill him or let him have fun with you. If you choose the latter, your character will have a random event further down the story, which might be a bit annoying. I have opted in to kill Haarlep. It won't be too demanding. At the start of the combat, he will summon few imps, but as we are able to regenerate after this fight, use all the power at your disposal to get rid of them. After killing the demon, head to the closest wall painting to the west of the bed and reveal hidden safe. Open it with the key from Haarlep's body or picklock it. Lastly, loot the entire room and use the water taps in bathing area to regenerate your party. That counts as a long rest and you can use it as many times as you wish. Remove the doors shrouding and head forward to the doors facing you. Lockpick them and you will reveal House of Hope treasury. Loot everything and continue heading west. Once you reach library room, Hope will appear next to the doors. For the best outcome, you will need to succeed on the throw to find the Archivist Fear. Once you enter, Archivist will face you. If you succeeded on the throw, you can pretend to be High Inquisitor, which will give you supervised but friendly access to the room. Now for the tricky part. Archivist will follow your character, and on the top of that, there are other skeletons tending to the room. Split your lockpicking character from the party, then get Archivist to follow the group to the opposite side of the room than the lockpicker, and steal everything while avoiding skeleton's sight. Maneuver Archivist with your party around the room as you progress until you claim all the loot, leaving your contract to the end. Once you looted the room apart of contract, split your party again. Leave one character that can use invisibility or character with invisibility scroll or potion next to the contract and move other three characters east through the first room to where we started. Once on the main corridor, look south to the round golden floor tile. There is an entrance to Hope's prison. Once in there, you will need to face two spectators and five imps. Dispatch them and use Orphic Hammer to destroy pillars that are holding Hope. Now, upon freeing Hope or picking up the contract, entire House of Hope will turn hostile, but all NPCs from the library will disappear. Use the character we left to pick up the contract, then use invisibility and run the same path as your party did to join them. Back in the main corridor, dispatch all the enemies until you reach the bedroom so you can have access to water taps that provide long rest, then regenerate and backtrack to the main room. Dispatch the group of enemies in there, then go back to regenerate again and head back to the first room with the portal back to Baldur's Gate. Time for the final boss, Raphael. If your gear is still alive at this point, he can join you in the fight against Raphael. Raphael himself will have 666 health points and 4 pillars located around the room that, unless took down, will provide him with massive bonuses. On top of that, there's also Mage responsible for House of Hope defenses and 6 demons. You will have Hope on your team to assist you, but whatever you do, do not use her divine intervention to deal damage in the room. In House of Hope, any holy damage dealt is also dealt to the character that did it. Using that spell will kill Hope, and we need her to survive this encounter to finish her quest. You can still use Divine Intervention from any other cleric if you have them in your party, and use Hope's one to get your party back to full health and all spells restored. If you wish to make this fight easy, place two rune powder barrels, one between left or right pillars and one in the middle of the room. Then move your group to the side without the barrel. At the combat start, trigger the middle barrel that will get rid of pillars, demons and severely wound the Raphael. Then just finish him off. Regardless of the outcome, I suggest keeping your gear and Hope safe. Your gear for the help further down the story, and Hope to receive the final legendary item. Once Raphael is dispatched and you have talked to both of your allies, your gear and Hope, leave the House of Hope back to the Devil's Fee. You should end up with 3 legendary items: Helldusk armor that provides 21 armor class, makes any wearer considered proficient with this armor automatically, inflict burning damage on the attackers if you succeeded on saving throw, provide resistance to fire damage, decrease any damage by 3, and provide fly spell. Gloves of soul catching provide 1d10 force damage on unarmed attacks, restore 10 health once per turn on unarmed attack, or advantage on next attack saving throw, and plus 2 to constitution up to 20. Orphic hammer, 4 to 13 damage, provide an advantage on saving throws against spells, and shackling strike action. It's quite important lore wise, so keep it close at all times. And also 4 very rare items: Amulet of Greater Health, constitution is set to 23 and you have advantage on constitution saving throws. Gauntlets of Hill Giant Strength, strength is raised to 23 and plus 1 to strength saving throws. Helldusk Helmet, you can see through magical and ordinary darkness up to 12 meters, you cannot be blinded and critically struck, you have plus 2 on saving throws against spells and provide spell immolating gaze. Staff of Spell Power, have 1d6 plus 2 damage, provide skill Arcane Battery that once per long rest allows you to cast one spell of any slot without spending the slot, and also provide plus 1 to spell save and spell attack rolls. Quick tip for Amulet of Greater Health and Gauntlets of Hill Giant Strength. They both set their respective stats to 23, which cannot be affected further. Get Withers to reset item's wearer and remove all bonuses to this stat, then redistribute it to other stats and use the item to compensate for it. And this is how you maximize the loot and deal with Raphael in House of Hope. See you next time.